My name's Tyrone. I'm a freelance street artist from Rotherham. This is my story.
Don't sweat the technique. Don't sweat the technique.
This piece here was actually done by my friend Alan. He's come a long way because when I went to school with him, he used to engrave the faces of mythical creatures onto the wooden desks in physics with the sharp end of his compass. So, and you see, you can just see how far he's come. So really does show in the right environment how people like Alan can thrive. Yeah, I mean, I like to come here and just enjoy myself. I feel the art is, you know, a real expression of the soul. Let's get out of this. What I like to do is that when I come here, I don't have a specific plan in place. I just sort of, you know, I get my paints and I get them out and I get ready and I just sort of think, you know, I want to allow the creative juices and energies and vibrations that are floating around, I say flow through me. And I listen to them and it's more like an out-of-body experience when I've got the canister in my hand. And it's just a flow. It's a real flow. I'm not thinking too much about it. I'm just there. I'm sort of letting what happens, and I'm moving and I'm flowing with the energies. Come with me. Some of the work I do is quite varied, actually. I've recently just been commissioned to do a 20-foot by 20-foot portrait of Master Oogway on the back wall of a kung fu gym in Wakefield. So, you know, it's really, you never know what's around the corner. Is this actually illegal? Oh. 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 A project I'm wanting to embark on soon is I'm gonna cover this entire wall with a layer of primer. And then I'm working on an A2 stencil of Ken Bruce's face from BBC Radio 2. And I think if I can just get that there, I think it really add a whole new dynamic to the space. You know, when I look out over this vast landscape, I see what the youth of Rotherham have built, and it's a special sight. Actually, really, you know, a lot of people, you know, they struggle in day-to-day life, but they come here and it's a real release for them. That's the hungry caterpillar. Fuck the police. You know, it's a dangerous game, but if you're willing to play it, the rewards you can reap are astronomical. If you just come down this way, it's a bit of a hazard, a bit of a health and safety issue. Have you got a permit? Before I embark on a piece of art, it's important to remember there are no accidents. Yeah? That's what I think of your system. Yeah, I was kicked out of school actually at 16. I pierced Ian Langford's arm with a shard of graphite. It's not something I'm proud of, but you know, these things happen. You know, I've always been a fan of art. It's not always been paintings either. You know, I'm quite a big music fan. I like it all. You know, you've got your jazz. I like a bit of disco, hip, hop as well. You should really recycle these canisters because, you know, a lot of that is highly combustible. These, if just left out in the open, so it's a pressurized can. When you embark on a piece of art, it's much like embarking on a journey. You know, you're not sure where you're going to end up. You're not sure how you're going to get there. But the important thing is that you set off. If you never set off, you'll never reach your destination. Whether that be a spiritual destination or just a destination within the physical realm of the actual artwork. We're all on a journey. And you know, sometimes that journey can take us down twists and turns, narrow paths. And sometimes you think, should I switch my Google Maps from a bike to a car avoiding motorways? But you know, if you don't take the bike paths, you won't learn anything. If you never go down that bike path, well, in some ways it'd be like being Master Oogway, but never using Kung Fu.